I hope you are enjoying this week on energy analysis. One of the key functions of energy analysis is to provide an improved understanding of the way that the energy use of households, of firms, a sector or of a country develops over time. But which factors are influencing our energy use? The first factor we can mention is simply related to what we do, the type of human activities we conduct in our everyday lives. We can sum this up under the term structure. Mankind first started with food products as an energy source to stay warm and generate power for basic household tasks. But as time went on, mankind has increasingly harnessed more energy sources, of which firewood was the first. Firewood was used for the production of light and heat, primarily for cooking. With the introduction of agriculture 10,000 years before Christ, the structure changed. Energy was since then also used for agricultural applications, food processing, transport. First, this was provided through draft by animals, and afterwards the first forms of hydropower and wind power were introduced. However, the big change occurred with the Industrial Revolution. Especially the use of fossil fuels became common practice in the 19th century. Coal and later oil products were used to supply heat to industrial processes and boilers for the generation of steam for steam engines. The next big change was around the year 1900, when power generated in coal and oil-fired power plants or hydroelectric plants could be transported through the grid. Nuclear power and natural gas were added at a later stage. The second big change in 1900 was the introduction of vehicles, such as cars, which transformed the transport sector to an important sector for energy use. Currently, it seems that we are in the early phase of the next transition. This is the transition towards an energy system largely based on energy from renewable sources. Let us now proceed to discuss structure in a more practical way, a way common in economics. Here, structure is generally used to describe the breakdown of a national economy into sectors, or in other words, to describe the mix of different activities. In this breakdown, you can see various levels of activities which can be distinguished in a modern economy. The structure can contain way more detail and levels in reality, but this gives you an idea about the divisions which typically may exist. The structure has a big influence on the energy use of a country. Different activities may differ in how much energy they use. A bank, part of the service sector for example, requires less energy to contribute $1 to the economy relative to a steel factory to contribute the same. So in general, the service sector, consisting of for example banks, schools and hospitals, is less energy intensive compared to the industrial sector. Hence, if the economy of a country is dominated by the service sector, the energy use will generally be lower than for a country with an economy dominated by the industrial sector. For example, the UK requires less energy per dollar than China. The second factor influencing our energy use is known as volume, or the amount of human activities we conduct. Volume is commonly described in monetary terms, such as gross domestic product, GDP. By doing more of something, the energy use will increase consequently. As we have seen before, for human activities, energy is required at an increasing rate. In this figure, you can see the development of the energy use per capita as function of the GDP per capita for some industrial majors, such as the USA, Japan, China, India and the UK. It is clear that with an increasing GDP, the trend for the energy use is also increasing, at least initially. For economies in strong growth or development, such as China, the increase in GDP is especially determined through industrial sectors. This economic growth will increase the energy use, which can be noticed as the inclined line in the early phase of economic development and industrialization. However, it is stabilizing after a certain point. How can we explain this behavior? The first part of the explanation is related to the two factors mentioned earlier. The correlation between energy use and GDP depends on which sectors are dominant. For developing countries, this is often the industry, which is energy intensive, leading to a strong correlation. But in the industrialized or developed countries, it is commonly the service sector which grows stronger. The service sector is less energy intensive, hence leading to a weakened correlation. For the second part of the explanation, we arrive at a third factor to take into account, next to structure and volume. And this third factor is energy efficiency. Under energy efficiency, we understand the amount of energy required per unit of activity of the various structure types. We see that over time, energy efficiency tends to improve. You can imagine that an increase in the energy efficiency will allow us to conduct the same amount of activities or even more at a lower energy use. This can help to stabilize or even reduce our energy use, even when there is economic growth. And the good news is, within the field of energy efficiency, a lot is still possible. To summarize, we can say that the energy use is predominantly determined by volume, doing more or less of something, structure, doing different things, and energy efficiency improvement, which entails using less energy per unit of activity. Thank you.